If you are writing a book or a long document in pages, at some point you may want to include an index for your readers so that they can easily find information. Unfortunately, that's not something that's quick or automatic in pages. However, I'm going to show you a process that I've been using for all my books, and it's pretty quick once you get a hang of it. You can start creating your index throughout the process of writing. However, in order to finalize your index, you will have to do it at the very final stage of your book or your document because you're referencing page numbers. And if you modify your pages, then it will affect the index and it will not be accurate. Once my book is final, I'm going to export it to PDF by going to File, Export to PDF. Then I'm going to open my pages and PDF documents side by side. I'm going to go to the section where I want to insert my index in pages. Then I'm going to use my PDF file to find any key, important information, phrases, words, terms that my readers will be searching for. At this point, you just include the phrases and terms, but do not include the page numbers because we're going to clean up this index first. Once I'm satisfied with my index list, I'm going to copy it and open an Excel file and paste it there. I'm going to use Excel to basically clean up my index. First, I'm going to sort this by going to Data and Sort in alphabetical order. Now, I know that there's a lot of duplication here, and because I was not really thinking about that when I was just going through my PDF and listing all the important key terms. I'm going to go to Home, Conditional Formatting, and then select Highlight Cells that are Duplicate. Once I do that, anything that's duplicate, I can select and then right-click and delete. Now, this removes duplicates that are identical. However, I still have to go through the index manually and remove any duplicates that were not identified by conditional formatting. Anything that's closely related but not identical is not found, so I have to manually delete it. Once my index is sorted and I removed all the duplicates, I can take a copy and then go to pages and paste it. However, you notice once I paste it that way, it creates a table, which is not what I want. There's a little workaround to fix that. Instead of pasting the terms in the body of the document, you first insert a text box. That's where you're going to paste the terms, then take a copy of them, and then remove the text box and paste them in the body of the document. Now you won't have a table. So I have a pretty good index. However, I don't like the formatting. There is a lot of white space. So I'm going to select the terms. Now you don't want to select the entire book, page, or section because I'm going to format the index into two columns. I'm going to select just the terms, go to Format, Layout, and then specify two columns. And now it looks really clean and concise. Now I am ready to finalize my index. I'm going to reference each of the phrases and terms in my index and search for it in my PDF. And then whatever page I find it on, I'm going to add it to my index. Now you want to make sure you just include the pages that make sense and leave out short references that don't help your readers. At this point, I may want to just clean up my index a bit by emphasizing some words and phrases. You can also add cross-references with a seal, also phrases, rather than duplicate the information. And then I can also add alphabet to make it easier for my readers to find key terms. Microsoft Word does have the option to index your documents. However, it's not as automated and quick as I would like it. If I export my pages to Word by going to File, Export to Word, the first issue is that the formatting changes. So for example, my glossary in pages is on page 218. While it's on 227 in Word. So that means I would have to go through my Word document and clean up to make the formatting consistent. If you want to stay with Word, you can insert an index by going to Insert, Index Tables. You can either mark phrases in your document to be included in an index or import a term file. Both require some work, which I will go over another time. However, you are now able to create an index in pages. So thanks so much for watching.